Welcome to the video news of the week. Authorities are continuing their investigation into the cause of last Friday's blast at the Millennium-designed muzzleloader Black Mag plant in Colebrook's Industrial Park. The series of explosions, which occurred at 1:17 p.m. on May 14th, took the lives of two employees, Jesse Kennett, 49, of Stratford, and Donald Kendall, 56, of Colebrook. Over the weekend, the Colebrook Chronicle provided updates on the story as it developed. On Tuesday of this week, we were able to film this footage of the blast area. A wide field of debris can be seen scattered throughout the area, along with what remains of the walls blown out by the blast, which could be heard as far away as 10 miles. Extensive coverage on this story can be found in this week's Colebrook Chronicle. On Friday, May 14th, Fiddleheads on Main Street in Colebrook unveiled its Northern Light exhibit in its new gallery. The exhibit will remain on display until June 28th and showcases 28 Northern New Hampshire artists. The display is a collaborative effort between the Arts Alliance of Northern New Hampshire, Camerata New England, and the gallery at the Old Mill Studio in Whitefield. One of the most unusual items on display was a trash can which has been transformed into a kaleidoscope by artisan Ron Edward of Berlin.
On Wednesday, Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital held its teddy bear clinic. Youngsters had a chance to view the facility, as well as the 45th Parallel EMS ambulance in the company of their favorite teddy bears and dolls.
That's a picture of your chest.
This past weekend, the North Stratford Baptist Church held its annual penny sale and silent auction at Fuller Hall. All sorts of merchandise and handmade items were on display.
On Saturday morning, our cameras caught up with two events in Pittsburgh. The annual law enforcement torch run to benefit the Special Olympics of New Hampshire was filmed as they approached Pittsburgh Village. The runners at this stretch were Dan Doolin and Robert Morin of the Border Patrol. Meanwhile, at the Pittsburgh Fire Station, the New Hampshire Snowmobile Association was about to host its annual meeting, held for the first time in Pittsburgh. Gail Hansen and Terry Cowell told us about the event.
Yeah, and this is an opportunity for delegates from the 115 member clubs statewide to come and talk about issues, talk about the direction of the association, make change in the organization through modifications of their bylaws, and to elect our officers. And additionally, it is also our award ceremony for different things that we pay tribute to each season.
The association publishes Snow Traveler News, which keeps enthusiasts informed of activities throughout the year. More information on the club is available at www.nhsa.com. This week, Area Key Clubs held a recognition event in Canaan. Here with a special report is the secretary of the Canaan Key Club, Albany Wilson.
Key Club members from Canaan and Colebrook and Pittsburgh took part in last Sunday's recognition event. It was an opportunity to showcase some of the many projects Key Clubbers have worked on over the past year. Among the speakers was Caitlin Parrington of the Colebrook Key Club, who presented her oratory essay, which won first place at the New England Convention.
The need to be perfect is more harmful than helpful. To think that I'm not going to stutter in this speech is an unrealistic goal. But to think that I'm going to stand here and give my message to the best of my ability is all I can do.
The three Key Club advisors were also recognized, Canaan's Renee Marchessault, Colebrook's Lindy Faulkner, and Pittsburgh's Norma Underhill, seen here with Judy Houghton of the Colebrook Kiwanis Club, pictured at the right.
Spring concerts are in full swing in area schools. Groveton's concert was under the direction of Andrew Tobin. In Colebrook, Misty Renard led youngsters through several spirited numbers. Molly Tobin at Stratford School conducted the chorus and musicians through numbers that ranged from a lummy stick demonstration to a minuet by Bach and selections from the musical Rent. Colebrook Academy school grounds were the site of an impromptu graduation Tuesday afternoon. Marta Zubiari, an exchange student from Spain, was leaving the school where she had spent the past year. Marta had been staying with the Hines family of Colebrook. Our thanks to Joy Hebert of Pittsburgh for sending along this little character out enjoying fine weather in the North Country. Look for partly cloudy conditions today with a high of 69 and a low of 43. Tomorrow, there's only a 10% chance of precipitation, with cloudy conditions and a high of 76 and a low of 51. Partly cloudy conditions continue on Sunday, with a high of 73 and a low of 51, with a 20% chance of precipitation. In sports action this week, the Colebrook Mohawks traveled to Pittsburgh for games against the Panthers on their home ball fields. Thank you for watching the video news of the week.